interesting about the player card system. If you do not know the answer, you may watch Competing with Underage Girls in Singapore, Singaporean Men Stealing Copper Wire, and How Singaporeans React to the City House Trap. With that, you may conclude that Singapore does indeed have a playing card system. This statement was not said by me, but the nephew of Singapore's Prime Minister. Singapore's Prime Minister nephew posted on his Facebook 3 days ago on 17 July about how petty the Singapore government is, because they actually took issue with a posting he made on Facebook for only his friends. Now, this is not the main point. The main point was actually said by the sister of the Singapore's Prime Minister. The sister of Singapore's Prime Minister also questioned, is there a bunch of people being hired by the Singapore's Prime Minister or the Singapore government to stop whatever young Singaporeans are posting on their social media, be it Facebook, Instagram, or whatever? To the extent that, are there people who are men and hired just to type a transcript of the YouTube videos made by young Singaporeans born after the 1990s? Do you think resources should be spent in such a manner? Why do you think that the Singapore government is doing such a thing to young Singaporeans? They also mentioned that there are dogs being hired by the Singapore's Prime Minister to broadcast certain people on their social media accounts. What do you think these dogs are being called? Are they being called the Internet Brigade, whereby they are there to bark at certain people, such as pressing the dislikes button, or posting negative comments and spamming comments, or reporting postings such that the video or that posting will get deleted? Why do you think they are being hired to do such a job? Is there something wrong with the transparency that has been mentioned, that they have something to hide, such as where our money is going? Like, for example, a part of our salary for Singaporeans are being taken away every month. Where is this amount of money going, and when exactly will it be returned to us? Will it ever be returned to us? And the next point is, shouldn't all these resources be spent on letting our healthcare and public housing be more affordable for the people, so that more young Singaporeans can get married, and that the healthcare premiums will be lesser, so that health of you do not have to die or commit euthanasia? Leave your comments down below and tell me what you think about our card system. Do you think that it's lying? And do you think that you have more examples to share with me? Leave your comments down below and remember to subscribe.